Hi everyone, Anthony here once again. We are back, yes, with Sue Ann. This is the JFWW Consumer Report Show. We are actually headed into Rosignol Butchery right now. We have to make some purchases to do our little life skills cooking show. I'm gonna be teaching Sue Ann how to make an excellent steak today, right? We have Claudius man in the camera. Claudius is also gonna be doing a nice red wine sauce. It's red wine you're gonna
use. Yeah.
Red wine sauce to go with the steak and everything today, so that's gonna be excellent. So let's walk inside and see what's going on. Not died yet. I still believe
you're
a woman, Sue Ann. But you
gotta
earn the right to be called a woman. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, so let's get a shot and see what's going on here. All the time when I come to Rosignol, it's always a clean place. This is the number one place that I come to buy all of my meats here in Guyana, in terms of getting your stuff ready, set up. Where all you have to do is, if it's chicken, just wash it. If it's beef or pork, just season it. You're ready to go. So straight out of the butchery, straight into the frying pan or onto the grill. All right, so today we know we have to pick up some steaks. So we are wondering if we can find some nice steaks to cook. If I see some good sirloins with some good marbling in it, I would utilize that. But right now I'm not seeing that, so we may just go with the fillet, right? So
look for that 9-to-10 ratio. Yeah.
Okay, I see. Does that say imitation tenderloin?
Yes, it does.
I'm not sure why it says imitation tenderloin, but we will ask the butcher. It's either it's a tenderloin or it's not a tenderloin, but I've never seen the term imitation.
Let me get a shot of that.
Tenderloin, yeah. It says imitation, right?
Where's that?
It's like right there. I don't want to put my hand over.
Okay.
It's right there, like right there. It's imitation tenderloin, right? We'll be able to zoom in on it. Maybe you could zoom in with the...
Oh, you could.
Yeah, you could, right? Just kind of zoom in. You see it? Imitation tenderloin, right? I've been... I've been a chef for, you could say, over 15 years now. I've never seen imitation tenderloin, so I am wondering, like, is it not real beef?
Yes, yes, he is that old.
Yes. What? Hi. Can you assist me? Yes. I'm interested in buying some beef fillet, but I am seeing, say, imitation tenderloin. Can you explain what imitation is about? The imitation tenderloin, is it close to the real imitation tenderloin or to the real tenderloin? What's the difference? Okay. Is it, does it come from the same part of the cow?
All is the same cow, but
okay. Do you have real tenderloin? Okay, so imitation tenderloin. I've just never heard the word imitation used in front of tenderloin. What's the difference between this one and the other one? Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. What other good steak cuts do you have? Do you have any good steak with marbling?
We have the shoreline, we have the ribeye, we have the...
What's your premium steak made from? What is your premium steak cut made from? You say premium, what part of the beef? It's from the bottom part of the leg or the hump? The rump. Did you taste it or smell? Because are you ever bite something? What do you mean? If I can have you at the buy-in, something would be wrong, right? For the owner of Rosignol, right? If a customer is coming in here and asking questions and he's videoing his movements around, he should have the legal right to do so because he is making a purchase from your place. If you are not comfortable with somebody doing that, then there's something wrong with having a business that is open to the public, right? Okay, may I please have a kg of a kilogram of the imitation tenderloin? Yes. Well, this is me just making my purchases at this particular moment, right? So
Did you try to
get that? Well, here's the thing. Technically, He's videoing me making my purchase, and we're testing service, and we're also testing the quality of the things that we're buying. Is your service not open to public? These are things that I'm just curious about.
You offer a service.
I offer a service and it's open to the public, and if somebody comes in and they to video them making a purchase. That's not necessary. Now maybe if I be doing a commercial about Jibu, that's a different story. But right now, this is actually part of a reality show, right? We're actually making a purchase, and we're testing quality and standards of the things that we're actually buying as a service, right? Now I know you're looking at me kind of irritated, but realistically, I'm not doing anything. Yes, but I'm here as a customer, and I am making a purchase, and I'm asking about the things that I'm purchasing about, right? If I'm not making a purchase, that's a different story, but I'm here to make a purchase, and I shop here many times before. Many, many times. I'm sure you know my face.
Yes, I know.
Okay, good. So why would there be a problem if I come and I'm videoing my actual purchase? What would be the problem in that? Well, it is for a review show. It is the JFWW Consumer Review Show, where we test quality, service, and products. We do it with restaurants, we do it with courts, we do it with a lot of different places, because it is important for people to know that you're getting good quality and service for the money that you're spending. Now, I have been recommending this place for a while to people, so I'm here to show people why I actually shop here. So I'm very surprised that you're here, kind of annoyed with me that I am spending money in this place and asking questions about the things that I am purchasing. Why? Explain it. Tell me. Why would you be annoyed of this? No, but this is actually live. So that's why I'm definitely interested in knowing. Why would somebody be annoyed with me videoing my experience in there? That is something that's very important. Do you not have cameras up in your business?
Yes.
Good. When I come in here and shop, am I not on your cameras? Can I ask you to take me off of your cameras when I come in here and shop? No, I can't, because it's for security. This is for consumer security, so that I can recommend a place if it's good. And if a place is not good, people can see what it is.
Yeah.
The Bureau of Standards should actually be doing this. By the way, Bureau of Standards in Guyana, this is technically your job, and you guys have not been doing this. But since we, the consumers, spend our money all over the place, we technically have to do it, right? And I would appreciate it if you could notify everybody that has a business in Guyana that is open to the public, to let them know that if somebody is videoing their experience, they have a perfect legal right to video their experience when they come as a customer into a publicly open business to showcase that experience to the rest of the world, right? So please, ministry, inform all business owners. Maybe you should put it up on a notice, put it in a newspaper. Who's ever in there sitting down and not doing your job, get your butts out there and send notices and make sure all business owners knows consumer rights, because that's important, as well as their own business rights, because that's equally important. I'm actually very, very upset that somebody came and spoke to me in reference to that, right? Yes, my dear. Yes, so the imitation tenderloin is what we are getting. You have a kg there for me? Okay, a bit. That's perfectly fine. In fact, we may need more, because we have we have about six people that we're going to be cooking for. So may I have another, that one there? Put that in there as well. All right, so maybe one or two of the people at the office today, you're gonna be short on your steak, right? So I'm probably gonna purchase some pork chops as well, right? And we're gonna show you how we handle the pork chops to all of you Muslim people out there, so that you know when we're dealing with pork, you need to keep those things separate.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today or visit our website, jobfairworldwide.com.
You have pork chops. All right, where are your pork chops? Okay, these are the rib chops here. Yes. Okay, and they're about an inch in diameter in thickness, which is really good for cooking a quality pork chop. May I also have a kg of that as well? And what I'm gonna do today, because I really don't feel like cleaning chicken and stuff like that today, I'm actually going to purchase some chicken breasts, and we're gonna make those chicken breasts. We're gonna do it for some chicken salad, and we're going to marinate it so that we can have some nice grilled chicken tomorrow with some veggies. Okay. Also, Rosignol does have some really good roasted pork and stuff that they would have already pre-made. Thank you very much. And you can also get food that is pre-seasoned. For those of you out there, you know, you don't have the time to cook, you don't have the time to season up. They've got some excellent seasoned wings here, right? They have a lot of other products already marinated and set, so all you have to do, buy it, throw it in your pan, cook it, and you are pretty much good. Do you guys sell wine here? Wine?
Wine. You could ask about the beef stock.
Do you have beef stock? All right, thank you. Yeah, so Claude, he actually needs the wine and the beef stock to make the sauce for the steaks, right? Because he's going to be making the sauce today, not me, so I'm very happy. That's going to work out. No beef stock. All right, well then. Yes, thank you very much. All right, so all the time, like I said, normally the service is really good here. You know, I'm a little disappointed about, you know, people getting upset with me about my shopping. Yes, good day. But I will encourage everyone in Guyana, you guys have a smartphone, be smart about it. When you're doing your shopping, do a little video. I know most of you take selfies. How about doing something that actually makes some sense and help people out, right?
The large one has a 6 cents showing up here.
Chad?
Yes.
Chad is here?
He's gonna be here.
Where is he?
My company.
We're going to need to buy a cow.
You told him I was cooking.
I didn't.
You snitched.
He asked me where I was.
You snitched. All of a sudden, he's not busy for the day. He's got time. Right? Okay, nice. Right? All right, thank you very much. Okay. Did I walk with money? If I didn't walk with money, well then I guess the lady that owns the place has a right to be very upset with me. Oh no, she can put me out and probably charge me or something, right? But yeah, so like most things, this is kind of your ticket, right? You better walk with cash or shut up and you can't really do much of anything else, right? So I went here and I got what seems good for, like, if it was one person, this would be meals for me. For lunch and dinner for at least a good week, right? And that would basically cost me about $6,000 in just, you know, my meat that I need. Which is all right. It's all right because I'm an expensive eater. I can't lie. Thank you very much. I am an expensive eater, so, you know, it can work out for me. But definitely they have other things that are a little cheaper, different cuts of meat, things that you could use for your pepper pots, your pickups, all of these things. And these are things that could be done right here that you can purchase quickly at Rosignol Butchery, right? So I'm gonna take back the camera for a minute, see our cameraman in the background. Thank you everybody, Rosignol. You did great. Tell the manager I didn't mean to piss her off or anything, so next time I come, like, don't spit in my beef or nothing, right? And see if you can get the real tenderloins, not the imitation stuff. It's gonna help out. All right, guys, take care. God bless. Bye-bye. All right, now we're about to leave from here, and we're gonna head down into the market to pick up our greens. So I think you put this in the car.
Yep.
To pick up our greens, this one. All right, like, seriously?
I'm looking for the county.
Right? Yeah, so we're gonna pick up our greens and the other things that we need, potatoes, stuff like that, to cook our luncheon to do the life skill show, right? I love making steak. It's very easy, it's very fast, which makes me wonder why it's always so expensive, okay? All right, guys, so that's it for right now. I will see you back after the commercial break when we are actually at Border Market, right, which isn't too far from here. You can probably see it in the background somewhere, right? It's the spot over there. Well, this, it actually looks a little clean from here.
There
you're
it
not
is.
Necessarily seeing the market.
In that
right?
corner.
Yeah, so you're not really seeing the market. But as we get to the market, you'll realize that, you know, hopefully you can use some improvements. All right, guys, so I'll talk back to you in a few minutes. Suan, yes. Suan is right there. All right.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today or visit our website, jobfairworldwide.com.
Hi, we're actually here at Border Market now. We just left Rosignol. A little bit of rudeness there, but other than that, we bought some imitation tenderloin and some real pork chops. Still trying to figure out what the imitation means in the tenderloin, but as soon as I get back to the office, I'm gonna Google that bad boy, right? So we're gonna take a little walk here, headed down to some of the usual people that I would buy some stuff from here at Border Market. I want you guys, especially those of you who are outside of Guyana, I want you to view the market area. And of course, Guyana is a small country. Rasmat! Bambore!
Greetings,
my boy.
Peace and love.
All right. Well, we're doing
with the family.
Well, we're moving with the family, yeah. We're actually doing a little show today, okay. So we're coming through the market, you know, pass by some of the people that I know here. We gotta buy some supplies, things like that, make sure that, you know, we're getting good supplies. And for the people who are doing good business, we wanna be able to send you guys more business. Let them know. Listen, if you're addicted to nicotine, come check out Rastaman. Right? Rastaman's got cigarettes, wholesale, all that stuff. Yeah. Push anybody, right? Aloe's hustler, right?
So
you gotta support people. Right?
I love this right now.
Yeah, no, I know.
Right now.
That's a working man. He's busy, he definitely on the move, right? All right. So, Rastaman, I can see you, buddy.
All right.
All right, guys, so yeah, let's walk around all of this traffic here and go to our usual supplier. All right. Yeah. So this is where all the trash from Border Market goes. Alright. So we are here today. I'm looking for who I call Auntie Jean, right? I call you Auntie Jean. Very respectable woman. Hi Auntie Jean, how are you doing?
Not bad.
We are actually here today. I'm actually doing a review show, right? These are all some of the members of our team.
Hi.
Right, I'm also bringing them to show them where I buy some of my products.
Oh.
Right, let them know who they should come to, who you can shop at. Auntie Jean does a lot of wholesale and goods too, right? So when you guys want some good prices, okay, you come right here, right? Right, Auntie Jean, long-term member with Jobfair, good person to buy things from. She is flex with you if she's a good person. You know, there's a lot of benefits to shopping from Auntie Jean. Okay, she has a wide variety of different products here. Right, from your coconut milk them to your onion, your potato them. Yeah, your bleach them, your aisle, toilet paper. So, you know, if you go in the bathroom, you need this stuff, right? So we're gonna see what we can purchase from her today, especially since we have to purchase some stuff for the cooking show. Okay, so I'm not really gonna buy a whole bunch of stuff today, just a few things that we need, and then we're gonna keep going from there. Auntie Jean, where Auntie Jean?
Yeah.
You get the minute?
14, 15, 20, right? I don't
mind
with 20.
40, right.
15, 16, 17.
Yeah, I don't watch Auntie Jean counting she money, you know. Good. Because I ain't want to hear no thief man running on Auntie Jean, right? Because then we got to come and hunt you out, done, right?
I do some wholesale over here too.
Yeah, exactly. Auntie Jean, she got a nice little setup here. Almost anything you need for household or your business, especially if you're a business owner, you're now starting out, this is a good place to come and shop. I used to come here and shop when I started my restaurant business here in Guyana. I was doing pretty well. Always gives me good prices, man. Always, always, right? And her stuff moves pretty fast, so you always have fresh stuff here. Okay? So, all right, Auntie Jean, I need some nice potatoes. All right, can you get me some nice big-sized potatoes? Right? I need about a good 5 pounds.
5 pounds?
Yeah, just 5 pounds, just for some baking. I'll take a bounty, because we do need some bounty.
Deal.
Right.
Take a box and throw the potatoes and pick up some big ones for me.
Let's see. I need flour, I need yeast.
Like how much flour you got? 4 pounds, 2 pounds?
Give me a 4 pound flour. We're gonna be testing out the Indorama stove that we picked up from Quartz the other day for the Quartz review. So we do want
some big ones.
Yeah, so we're gonna be doing some, and make sure they're firm, right?
Mm-hmm.
Nice and firm, thank you. Right, we're gonna be doing some baking reviews and seeing how well that stove and that oven works, right? We're gonna be checking it for danger signs, things that you should be aware of when you're purchasing those stoves. You know, we're gonna be testing it out completely, and then we're gonna be testing out the food, right? Because it's not good if we beautiful, beautiful. Exactly. Thank you very much. You see, this is why I like Auntie Jean. She's not going to try to oversell you just to make a buck, right? She's going to tell you exactly what you need. If you already know what you need, you give her that information, and she'll help get you the right things. I also need a nice tub of butter. What butter would you recommend?
Golden cream.
All right, golden cream. You recommend we local style?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, right. Sterling products, right?
Yeah.
I hope you're listening, Auntie Jean. She really promoting you butter. Golden cream is them, right?
Golden cream.
It's Sterling,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, yeah, Sterling. Let me make sure, right? I have a different company.
Calling the wrong people.
Calling the wrong people, eh? So Sterling, I hope that you see the Auntie Jean for years. She's been here. She's been working, pushing your butter all the time. And y'all ain't even come and put up a nice little sign for she. Y'all ain't doing nothing for this woman. These are the hard-working people that is keep Guyana moving.
And she is 65.
She's supposed to be retired. She's supposed to be doing things.
But me right? Retiring.
And she can't afford to retire. The country too hard right now. She got to push your body, right? So, you know, help people out. Exactly, right? You hear the money background. Too much of bills, right? You got tax of this, tax of that, tax of this, tax of that. You know, paying market fees and fines and everything. And yeah, you know. And we can't even get things in order. I've been shopping here for years and years and years, and this market has not changed. Right, we had local governments, we had general elections, we had all of these things. People are voting for you guys, and you guys ain't really doing too much. So I'm hoping that you guys see this, right, and just address the issues of the population. That's all you need to do to get votes, man.
That's it.
Just fix the issues, man. Make things convenient for the people in the country, and I'm sure you will get the support that you need. Okay, we also need to pick up some fruits and vegetables. So, Auntie Jean, just set up everything for me.
Okay.
I'm gonna walk down this side, and we're gonna continue to look for
the potato, the flour, the butter, and the yeast, right?
And the yeast, yes, exactly. It. And she just got me, baby. Oh God, y'all, women get jealous. All right, all right. So let me see what's really going on here. Hey, what type of steamed greens you guys want, man? It's tea. What's up, guys? Hey, who got some broccoli?
Yeah.
Oh gosh, these are some people I haven't seen in a very long time.
Well, at least every time I hear you come and me not see.
Why I just come, but then there's a lot of movement. You know, we built in the house and scheme up in land. Okay, I decided not to do it as a farm. We actually got a 3,000 acre piece of land on the highway that we're doing the farm at. But that's actually turning into a complete housing scheme.
Okay.
Right, so it works out better. It's good to see you. The other day I passed by, I see your son. Right, I collected a number of them. I'm going to be calling you guys later because I want to talk to you about some business in a different area. Right? Can I get the tree pong tomato, please?
Sure.
Also, y'all got broccoli?
Yes.
You got nice broccoli?
Uh-huh.
Let me see.
What part of the highway?
We're actually doing a live. We're actually doing a live show right now.
Okay.
It is a review show. It's called the JFWW Consumer Review Show. Where basically everywhere we shop throughout the country, whether it's courts, whether it's stuff, we want to show people the service and the quality that we get, right? So that we can recommend them as to where to come and shop.
Here is the part of the macaroni.
I can talk to you more about that later on. That's a joint venture.
That's a joint venture.
So I can tell you what's going on there. Also, I'll take some bananas too.
A pine
and a nice watermelon. You got watermelon?
Yeah. What size watermelon?
Like this. Not too big, not too small.
Like this.
Yeah, like this. Like this, right? I say this might be maybe a $400 or $500. And you know, something like that. Right?
This is an highway.
Yes.
This is where we is right now.
But I want to be able to come up and take some shots of the farm. You see, one of the reasons why I like to come to this particular vendor here, right? They're not a third party vendor, okay? They have their own farm, in fact, one of the best farms in the country. It's one of the cleanest and most well put together farms I've come across here in Guyana. In fact, they've encouraged me even into farming, right? But they do it right, okay? So when you want to know that you're getting quality greens, come and check out Sugar Them, right? There's a few other people in the market as well that I could recommend, right? We got Fat Girl, who is straight true Guyanese crack there. And I gotta recommend she, because, you know, she'll sell good thing. Right? Yeah, that's beautiful. That is beautiful. Right? In fact, can you send me some of these on WhatsApp? Let your son send it to me on WhatsApp. Right? Take back my number. 62. Okay, yeah, he has my number then. Excellent. I'll take a pack of carrots too. I'm gonna need some sweet pepper. Yeah, I don't have no hot pepper to make pepper sauce. Alright, who can I get that from right now? Alright.
Down the cross street.
Okay, we'll go through the cross street then. We're gonna get some hot pepper there. Right? Yeah, but we're gonna take some of these smaller sweet peppers, not the big ones. Not much, just give me a pound of it. I don't need to like people what I'm doing today. Right, and let me get a small cabbage. Actually, you know what? No, we have cabbage here, so we can deal with that. But we got the bananas, got the pine, we got a watermelon, and I need a nice papa. Right? Right, so, and we're going to get a nice papa here. And how's your lettuce going?
$100.
All right, can you pick me out two nice lettuce? All right, yeah, guys. So, I like to eat my food, especially since we're making steak and stuff today, and we're making pork chops. I definitely want a nice salad to go with that. Okay. I do want to show a little support to some of the other businesses here and other vendors here. So we're gonna need some salad dressing as well. I don't plan on making dressing from scratch today, right? I have all of these things we need at the kitchen there. So let's go ahead over here and see if they have any salad dressing. Hi, Auntie. How you doing? Right. You got any ranch dressing? No salad dressing. Who can I get some salad dressing? The other box. Okay, so we're not gonna get any salad dressing here, but we're gonna get it in the next part of the market, right? So what I'm gonna do is, since we got a little bit more of a walkthrough to do, sugar, I coming back just now, right? Just bag up everything. Let me know my price. I'm coming right back through. All right, so let's go. Why is we at the market? Sorry, Auntie. Right? Why is we at the market? It's a good thing if we go ahead and we get some fresh coconut water, right? Good place to get some coconut water from, right? We got some of our local fruits out here, mangoes, tamarind. Hi, Auntie, how you doing? How's your tamarind going, Auntie? 200? All right, let me get a pocket of tamarind. All right, tamarind, very healthy, people. Very, very healthy. Chad, you're gonna collect this from Shino? And we're gonna go ahead and get some coconut water from the coconut guy. Alright, so go and get some nice coconut water here. At least a bottle. Good potassium, right? Uncle, I ain't seen you in a little while.
Yes.
Like I've been gone, eh?
We're actually doing one of our shows live right now, and I'm bringing them here to buy some coconut water. Right, so I need a bottle of a nice sweet coconut water. And I know you're gonna hook me up nice here. Right? For those of you, right, this is a Guyanese experience. I also need. Hey, Chad! You want coconut water? What? Water? No water? Yeah. Suwan ain't saying no.
Uh-uh.
And then we get 3 coconuts to use here while you're here. I'm so sorry. My condolences to you and the family.
That's why you don't see them.
I haven't really been around too much either. I've kind of been in and out.
Hi there.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We'll take 3 fresh nuts. Just 3. Yeah. As you would notice, right? I'm pretty much on a first name basis with like everyone here that I shop from. It's important that the people that you regularly shop from, that you know them well, Chad. Don't make jokes. Right? That you know them well. You know, we're a connected community, man. We're all over all of these people, you know, supporters of the network work that we do. And you know, once again, you know, to Uncle here, my condolences. Right? And despite whatever, you know, it's a little crazy that all of these people, and you would notice there's a lot of older people having to run their stalls just to keep themselves floating, keep things rolling, right? We need to have better systems in place, right? Right, we definitely need to have some better systems in place. Let this gentleman come through, right? All right, so this is a very good coconut.
Uncle, you did me justice. Get me a sweet, sweet coconut here.
Oh, that, oh yeah, that's Suano.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're welcome, dude.
Mm-hmm. This is past 57 years.
57 years this man that here working.
Myself, my father, my brothers.
Family business. Exactly.
4 generations they are here.
And where do you primarily get your coconuts from?
From Northwest.
Okay, excellent. So this one I'm drinking now, can you tell me which batch is this? Is this a Northwest batch?
Yes, Northwest.
This is a Northwest batch?
Yes.
Alright, Northwest, right? Maybe Pomeroon side?
Yes, that's right.
Alright, Pomeroon coconut right here, right? You know you could come here and get Pomeroon coconuts from Border Market. Right on Orange Walk and North Road by this car. Watch me, I'm pushing my hand. Uncle chopping like crazy.
My name is Uncle Buddy and Sons.
Uncle Buddy and Sons.
Yeah.
Right?
It's on the pier. Man.
Yeah, you're supposed to have your stuff out there already, right? But we're still gonna push it a little harder, right? Not a problem. We also got, we partnered them over here, right? So don't feel like we racial, we only film equity people, right? Right? We got, we partner over here, and he sell good coconuts too, right? So let me let you know what's going on. So normally when I come, I just support board businesses. Right now he's a little busy, so we try to give him a little business as well. That's how they do, they live together, right? Right, so, you know, understand that in Guyana, the racism and stuff is basically in the politics and it's not really in the people. So understand how that stuff works, right?
So you want one thing?
Yes, please.
All of us, we selling here. Of course, we selling before them, but from the time they came here, we have a good relationship.
Exactly, it's a good relationship, man. People live good with one another. And that's the whole thing, right? It's only like around elections and stuff. You find people changing attitude in this country, right? Yeah, so we got to get out of that, right, Guyana? We got another election coming up. And I think...
Let me just tell you one to my father, right?
What going on, buddy?
These guys are good and everything, man, but I don't trust them with women. My woman.
Oh, son. Them coconut man, them the Steve people woman.
These chaps got a little foot, man. When this man take your woman,
brother, there, oh, gosh. Well, you know, all the coconut water by his power, eh? The power. You see, remember I was telling you earlier about your wife going to the market for 3 hours, right? Be careful. It might be the coconut man. Right? So know what's going on. Right? Yeah, so take this bad advice. If you're out for tech people, woman, drink a lot of coconut water.
This coconut water selling.
Coconut water, and he's selling it. So, alright, don't send your wife to the coconut man. Right? You might not get your back. Right? Right? Uncle, you want to bust this nothing off of me? Thank you very much. It looks like it got some nice jelly. Right? This looks like it has some really nice jelly. You know, I know some people come and they talk about jelly nice. I want to show them what the nice jelly look like. I'm not even watching. Is that chopping happening? I'm just hoping that I'm not too close. Right?
That's it.
You know, and this is a very dangerous job, you know. People don't understand. This is a dangerous job. If you ain't up on your medi, okay, or if you ain't focused, you can lose a finger, you can lose a hand, accidentally lose a relative that you're not too fond of, accidentally, right? So this is some very good coconut jelly, right? It's even got a little bit of the grums in there, but that's all right. All of that is natural, right? So, yes, and this is our definition of a spoon here in Guyana when it comes to coconut. You take this piece, you dig it out, and you see how that jelly looks? I don't even want to tell you what it looks like, right? Because if I only said that, then I definitely would not put it in my mouth. But it is definitely full of power, right? Mm. Yeah, this will explain why I have so many children. Because I buy coconut them from uncle.
God.
Yeah, if you're a man out there, when you're having problems, right? Getting your girl pregnant. And you can get steel dropped.
Yeah,
Uncle.
Yes.
Uncle, you just want to set the woman back up around this place, you know. You ain't want no man coming shopping. Steel drop coconut water. Chopping. Yeah. How old are you, Uncle?
72, son.
72.
What
is man more powerful than plenty of them young man them who are smoking weed from Carno? Talking like thinking about thiefing. Carrying gun, don't know how to load it. Right? Right?
Preach.
No, I saw that the other day. I saw a young man carrying a strap. He didn't even know how to load the gun. It was funny as hell. Mm. You have something to rinse off? I just want a little bit of water. Thank you very much. This is okay. Yes. And you know when your hands get a little messy from the coconut water, remember, the coconut water in itself doesn't stain, but the stuff from the shell, the husk, actually does stain you up a little bit as hell. And I just said that and then brushed up against Chad's coconut, right? I'm surprised you still got coconut left.
Same.
Right? All right, so let's see, what else do we really need? I think we picked up everything from Gene and everything else from Sugar and them there. Yeah, so that's pretty much it at this moment. I'm just waiting on my team to finish eating their nuts. And then after they're done eating their nuts, we can go and pick up the rest of our fruits and vegetables and get back to base and start the cooking show aspect of this particular review here. Right, so remember, if you need good coconuts, come to the Nut Man, them.
Uncle Buddy,
right?
And Sons.
Uncle Buddy and Sons. And what's their business name?
Wickham.
Huh?
Vincent.
Vincent, and you can come to Vincent Wickham Coconut Stand. The only thing is, the only complaints we get about this stand is when your woman come here, she don't want left. Okay? So know what's going on. Right? And it's a red man said that. Red man, that we red man dangerous. So when we complaining about loss, understand, something serious going on. We can see you back after the commercial break. Thanks.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today or visit our website, JobFairWorldwide.com.
All right, guys, so we just got back to Sugar Style, right? And we're here to basically pay for our stuff, find out our prices. How much you got for eating, buddy?
35.
We got everything.
All right, and we got everything, yo. So, yeah, for like $3,500, I was able to buy everything that I needed for this particular cooking show, which is going to be basically feeding about 7 or 8 people inside the office today. If you count Chad as
10, including Chad.
If you count Chad as 2 or 3, or as his sister saying 10, right, then we have a lot of people there. There you go. To be feeding today, right? Okay, so this is everything here?
Yeah.
Alright, thank you guys very, very much.
You too.
Chad, you wanna take this stuff?
That's a papa, and you have, yeah. No, that's a pineapple.
Uh-huh.
Exactly.
So, thank you very much for shopping with us today, sir. Right? That'll be 5,000.
I need to make a profit.
That's how business is done, right? Job here, we hustling all the time. Right? All right, thank you guys very much.
So we got to catch up with you.
Yes.
We can't talk anything over food. We got to sit down.
No, no, we got to sit down and talk, definitely. It's good to see you again.
Okay, thank you.
All the time. All right, guys.
When I got the screech cough, and say, oh, that's my friend.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. All right, we're going to pause it for a moment because I do need to go and pick up some hot peppers, which isn't nothing big, right? It's just, unfortunately, today they don't have it in stock. They're probably all sold out. But normally, you can come here and get all of your produce supplies. Okay, guys? So be back in a couple minutes.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today or visit our website, jobfairworldwide.com.
We are about to test out this Mabe, right, microwave, right? Hopefully it does not give us the same problems that the Mabe fridge gave us. Once again, right next door to the microwave, you can see the fridge here. This is actually the replacement fridge. We do have to wait a few more hours, maybe about another 8 hours before we can safely plug it in. But now, one thing that I find a lot of microwaves have problems with are baking potatoes. Okay, from being in a restaurant industry overseas, sometimes the quickest way to get a good baked potato is to use a microwave. Now, I have a really, really awesome Panasonic microwave. I also have a Magic Chef, and I have like two other microwaves in my other homes. They're really, really good. And normally, it doesn't take me more than 6 minutes to cook a potato about this size, all right? So, I'm hoping I'm gonna run maybe a 10-minute test on 3 or 4 of these to see how well they will get baked inside this microwave, okay? Because we do want to bake potatoes to eat with our steaks, our pork chops, salads, and all the other food that we have been preparing here today, all right? So, first thing, of course, the microwave is stainless steel, reflective cover, very much like the Yalicia Indorama stove. The inside is spacious, so you do have space, and this space is important for heat distribution. So what I'm going to do now, since everything in my microwave is clean, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a few potatoes in here. I don't want them super duper close to one another, but I do want to get, in fact, I'm going to put the biggest one directly in the center, right? And we are going to bake a couple potatoes for the team. Big fan of baked potatoes. For those of you who don't know, like this one, we're not going to bake him, right? He looks like a retarded potato, so he will go into stews or curry, right? This one here, though, will work out. So let's see, capacity. It's holding 7 baked potatoes comfortably, or potatoes that will be baked comfortably. I don't see a baked potato or a potato setting here, right? So those, they do have a potato setting here. All right, I want to test it, but at the same time, I'm a little nervous in testing this potato setting. So that's maybe about 3 pounds of potatoes. Yeah, give or take. So that I'm pressing 3 and I'm getting a 6. I have to find out what these codes are actually for. So it helps if you read the manual. But just to be safe, right? Because I'm not reading the manual right now. I don't really have time for that. I'm going to put it on, I'm gonna run it 6 minutes first and see what happens and how it's cooking within that 6 minutes. Check my power level. I guess this is 100, all right? 20. So 100, so it's 100% power level here. And I'm going to turn it on. So that's gonna run for about 6 minutes and we will get back to it in 6 minutes and see how it is working out.
but it looks like the carousel is working pretty good in there. Okay, anything else you see is because of the reflective cover, right? So, just letting you know. Now, we can actually turn our attention over here, because over here is where the magic is about to happen. We have one pan all the way over here that's gonna be handling our pork chops, and we're going to be searing our steaks in this pan here. So let me just get steaks and the pork chops ready. Right, we're ready 40 seconds in on the potatoes there. At the same time, right, we do have, where is my little pot? Okay, my little pot is right here. I'm coming back over there because I do want to make my carrots. We're just gonna steam these carrots, right? So I'm just using a little, small, little regular pot here. So I'm just gonna steam these carrots. When these carrots are tender, not completely mushy, but tender. Once they are tender, then we can utilize them for our purpose, right? So I'm just gonna put this over here. I don't, actually don't even want that too close to, yeah, that could work. All right, so just put that there. And working on the stove, right? Lower that fire there and just let that boil for a little bit. Now is the fun part. Turn on one flame, turn on two flames. So very easy to light up. I do want to control the heat here. So I'm gonna drop it down slightly. I need it hot. I don't need things burning. This has a wider base. I'll still control this flame here. All right, now some people use butter. I find the butter has a higher, lower smoking temp, so butter tends to burn and discolor your meat really, really fast, so you can't get an adequate look at the cooking, right? Meat, on the other hand, I would use olive oil. You could also use regular oil, right? So if you don't have olive oil, you can go to a little cheaper route, which ain't bad, right? And I've used regular oil before without any problems when cooking my stuff. This here is for the pork. This here is for the beef, okay? Make sure you keep these things separate, and if you have chicken cooking at the same time, you would have separate utensils for your chicken, okay? Don't think that you're just gonna do things wireless and it's gonna work out very nice for you, because you don't want that stress. I'm just putting these here so that they start cooking. This beef is gonna cook fast, right? Reason why I tell you this beef is going to cook fast, this is the beef that we purchased from Rosignol Butchery. It was labeled as imitation tenderloin. Basically, I think that is false advertising, because it's not tenderloin in any which way, shape, size, or form, right? And I don't think that they should be advertising it as tenderloin. That's tricking people. This beef is too... it's too tough to be called tenderloin, right? It is it's basically like a cut from the roast, which is a boneless piece that they should be using for mince, special mince, or other things. But I see that they are charging a tenderloin price, so I did not mind buying. But I am a little disappointed in Rosignol advertising things that way, because for somebody who does not know, or if you are following a recipe that I might give you on my cooking show, which might involve a tenderloin, you may actually go there and buy that not realizing it's not going to be tender, right? And you know, even an imitation tenderloin should be tender. Touching this beef just now, we had to beat it with the bell. No, I had to get the fattest person inside my kitchen to pong it out, right? We had to use some ginger, some stiff salt to start breaking it down and tenderizing it. So you know, we didn't have time to soak it in pine juice or soak it in a salt brine, right? Which would actually defeat the quality of the steak, just completely change it, right? So Rosignol, please stop advertising boneless beef as tenderloins, because it is not. And some people may get very upset if they realize that you are charging them tenderloin prices for something that they could have gotten for a fraction of the price. Just to let you know the difference, right? I believe a kilogram of their tenderloin beef that they're selling there is like $2,700 Guyana dollars per kg, okay? And
the type of meat that it actually is. You can go to a regular market style and get that same beef quality for around $400 per pound or around $800 per kilogram, which means they are more than doubling up the price on it. So I think that that is very unfair. Also, that would explain the attitude we received when we went into Rosignol. They're probably going to ban me from there. And if they ban me from there for this, well, just note that I will find somewhere better. We do have other butchers that we can utilize. No sense in making them rich if they are selling us crap. Okay, so first thing is going in here. This isn't even a proper pork chop. You have some in here that are proper pork chops, but I noticed they shifted in some other cuts in here, right? But they are charging you top quality pork chop prices, right? This is about an inch in diameter. So we're gonna put him. Any friend here? Both of that is going down. By now, this pan should be hot enough to start searing this beef. Yes, it is. Very hot. In fact, it's not just hot. It does not want to loose. Okay. So, right away, you can tell this beef doesn't really have any real fat content in it. It just sticks right away to the pan. Very, very lean beef, which is good if you're on a special type of diet. But other than that, this beef, not really good for searing properly. So let's see what happens here with this. Temperature control is always a must when you're cooking. So focus on ways to control your temperature. So I took it off the fire a little bit to keep everything from sticking, and you know, for Chad and you guys out there who might not be used to doing this. Now I do have another cook in the kitchen with me, okay, and that is Claudius. So Claudius, you will monitor the beef.
Yeah.
And then you know you like your beef rare. Uh-huh. I wouldn't advise taking this beef rare. Uh-huh. It's not the right cut of beef for you to work it down rare, right?
Yeah.
If it was, be a different story.
Even for
we're looking at maybe about 5 minutes each side. If that take a cut, but it just depends on how much you want to cook. Please don't rush your hand on my microwave. Okay. Right? Especially since the microwave is part of this review today. Mm-hmm. Right? Let me just check here. Not ready to flip yet. Right? Now I hear the microwave beeping in the background, so that first 6 minutes has passed for the potatoes. So we're actually gonna switch back over here and check on the potatoes. And let's see how these potatoes are working out. So by now, you can tell they're not even halfway where they're supposed to be. One or two of them feeling like it's already getting a little soft. That's okay, so it's not as powerful as the Panasonic. I will tell you that I can do that with my Panasonic and get a lot more reaction. I'm gonna put it on for another 6 minutes and I'm gonna let that ride. Okay, because I definitely want these potatoes to be soft and tender for the baking purposes. All right. Now, one of the last things that we're gonna do, Claude, is we're gonna be baking this sauce. Right. One of the last things that we're gonna do for it.
What sauce are you making?
We're just gonna make like a little onion saute sauce with some garlic, just something just to spice it up, give you a little look, make sure that the beef isn't dry. Because chances is with this quality of beef,
yeah,
we might experience some little dryness in and out.
No marbling, it's gonna be.
Yeah, so it's gonna be tough. But hopefully if we cook it right, it is not overly tough, right? So should work out. My big sister, when I was growing up, she used to cook the roast, so. She used to trick me and tell me it was steak until I got enough sense and I realized she was lying to me. Alright? You're a liar, sis. But you know that. I love you though, but you're a liar. Kind of screwed up. Had me eating tough, horrible, hard meat all the time. Not good. See? So, yeah. You know, so that's why for me, as a backup, I have my pork chop. Right? Pork is by far more tender than beef, but I do know some people like beef. We've got some Muslims around, so
You don't want them affiliated with the pork that's cooked over here. That's why it's like a complete burn away, so no chance of anything. If you're Hindu and you're watching this thing, don't worry, man. We're going to do a vegetarian and a chicken and a fish episode probably next week, a week after the next. No, actually, next week is Brazilian week, right? Because I realize we have a rotisserie in this oven. So next week is definitely a Brazilian week. We could do a couple nice whole roast chicken. But that we have to brine. We're going to brine it before we roast it. Soak it down good. All right.
What do you usually put in your brine?
Huh?
What do you usually put in your brine?
It depends on who I'm cooking it for. With me, basically salt, paprika, certain other spices that I got there. I can't give away my brine recipe on TV, right? Because it's actually in my cookbook, which is the Awesome Chef Cookbook. Check it out online. If you need copies, every now and then we'll actually be putting out some free recipes out there on our channel. Things to help you guys out. Now, I want you guys to know, right, we're about to make restaurant quality food right here in our home. All right, and we're going to feed approximately about 10 to 12 people, which is pretty cool because that means we're doing meals for about 10 to 12 people on about a $20,000 to $25,000 budget. Right, which isn't bad, and giving them some fairly high-end quality food. This fire is getting a little too high. We also still have, we have some bread in the oven. You want to step back from there for a second? Let's get a good shot of what's going on with the bread. Let's see. See if you could see it with the light on from here, if you could see it in. Okay, you see some bread in there. You see our bread, they look like pillows. But let's get more of a direct look there. Yes. Just don't put the phone too much into it. Right? I don't want the heat damaging my lenses. All right, but yeah, so this bread is baking nice. Close that back up. We've got it running on about 350 degrees Fahrenheit temperature right there, give or take. All right, I like this. When I see this caramelization at the bottom there, all I can think about is if we had the wine to deglaze it with the little beef stock. So, man, nice little sauce there. Right.
Searing a bit slowly.
Alright, so then we're gonna turn up the fire.
That's gonna be on grease.
Yeah. Beef, something, especially a cut of beef like this, you want to cook it as fast as possible. But at the same time, you don't want it to burn. Okay, so it's gonna take a few minutes here. And when we get back, you see you got me and you got Chef Claude, right? Little French guy in here. Alright, and yeah, definitely. And we're gonna make it as easy as like 1, 2, 3, or 3, 2, 1. Man, don't even worry about this, children in Guyana. Y'all done got plenty of problems talking, and this man's shirt will mess you up even more, right? But we're gonna keep it as easy as 1, 2, 3, and show you how to do some very simple things. We've actually got a very nice salsa and everything that we made. Got a few things at the side, right? Because you can't eat beef alone. That don't make sense, right? So when we get back, we're gonna show you some of the finished products that we have, and you'll tell us how they look, and I'll let you know how long it's actually taken to cook. So yeah, compared to my Deco, because I do have a Brazilian Deco stove, but it's a much bigger stove, bigger burners, everything. I mean, that's like, I don't know, like 36,000 BTUs, right? So there's a lot.
So
it's something like 6 is the converter, something like that. I'm not sure, man. But I make curry in 15 minutes on that stove, right? And normally my pork chops, they would have already been cooked, but it is a bigger stove that is more commercial.
About 2.2 million G80. If you use 6.
Possibly, right? Yeah, he's a number guy, right? I just know if things taste good, that's looking all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's looking all right, yeah. Yeah, that's looking all right. Okay. See, that's the problem with this tough meat. That's the problem with the tough steak. This isn't even steak, guys. I can't even call it steak. Rosignol, man, y'all let me down. You guys let me down, man. I could have went to the butcher shop and got things cheaper. But once again, it is a review show, and it is what it is. Okay, I hit my potatoes. My potatoes beeping over here again. So let me check on them, see what has been happening. You can see some steam coming out of there. I hope you can see the steam. That means it's probably gonna be hot. Uh-oh, I still had these little plastic things in here, so let me pull these out. Okay, So good thing it's not a regular oven, or this would have caused a fire. Right, let me just, I'm busy cooking potato in here and didn't know I still got these little stickers. Like I said, it's a brand new microwave oven that we are testing out. Okay, so my potatoes are getting cooked. So for 7 potatoes, 12 minutes, I'm still going to put it in another 3 minutes and let that ride. Let's see how best we can get things in order here for our potatoes to actually have the right texture and quality. So when we come back, we're going to tell you how all of these things are working out. You know, as you can tell, we are shooting live. This is not rehearsed in any which way, shape, size, or form. Right, it's all part of our reality show that we're doing here with Jobfair Worldwide. Like I said, we plan on covering business, we plan on covering home economics, we plan on covering agriculture, we plan on covering food safety, health, operational health and safety. A lot of different things we're gonna be covering in this show. Peer pressure, right, underage sex, all sorts of things that has happened and why people should or should not be doing these things, right? You know, from if there's a pastor in your area and he's doing something he probably shouldn't be doing, we'll be covering that as well, right? Because it is about building a better Guyana, and all of these things are required in restabilizing the moral fabric of our country, right? You can't fix the top if you can't get the bottom in order either, right? So, understand, when you're doing this thing, if you want to fix certain things in Guyana, you got to fix it on all levels, not just the top. Because if you leave the problems at the bottom... Okay, you see those big plates that I got there? Stack them, because that beef got to rest. Because that's the only way we can guarantee that beef is going to be a thing. Can I see this tong for a minute? This is something. Okay, yeah, cooking any more than this is stress. I do like to see a nice browning.
Yeah, we got a decent here.
We got a good sear. We got a good sear on both sides. All right, plate those bad boys. Just plate all of this beef in one plate. Yeah, one plate is for the pork. One plate is for the beef. Keep this closer here, right? Mm-hmm. I don't want my nice new stove get too nasty, right? I proper views people from the stove, right? Now this here. What's going on here? We do need, add in a little bit more olive oil. I noticed that I took it off of the fire when I was doing this, because you do need to control that heat. You don't want it too hot like we had it before and everything was just sticking. Spread it out good. Consider the space that you're working with in there. So notice that we do have the carrots, which are cooking on one stove, and the carrots have not been cooked thoroughly yet, but the beef has already finished, and the carrots started before the beef. I should probably turn up the burner for the carrots a little bit. Okay, this is this one. This is this one. Let me turn up the carrot burner a little bit. And check this out. All right, so my pork chops are starting to look good. They're not quite ready yet. I like to burn off this fat, melt this little fat that's on the side here. Not completely, because this particular fat has a lot of flavor in it, right? And you would be losing good flavoring. But I don't like the fat to feel fatty in my mouth, right? That's not very good, right? You're getting some shots too. Excellent, excellent. Alright, so let's see. This side is looking very good. But you notice here, I don't like this here, so this has to cook down more so that we can get all of that out. But my pork is looking very, very good. Might I say pork will have a longer cooking time than beef. And chicken will more than likely probably have the longest cooking time out of all, because of the dangers associated with chicken, such as typhoid and salmonella. Alright.
How long do you rest it for?
I did this will rest for about 10 minutes. Add a little time for the juices to settle. After you put your first set of oil in this pan to cook these pork, you don't really need to put back in any oil, because the pork will release its own fat and oil, right? Which has some flavor. I'm gonna come back over here and check on my potatoes in just 3 minutes. I got some deep potatoes. Are feeling like they've been properly cooked. So let us see what's going on. This big one though, he needs flipping. He's not cooked yet. Small one. Okay, those are pretty cooked. Let me get something for those. In fact, I can put those right here. Ooh, hot potato. Hot potato. Very hot potatoes. All right. You know what? Taking a chance. Feeling it. Feeling it. All right. And these potatoes need to rest too before they're served. Chad, I got a job for you. Do you want to grab these potatoes? Here, hold on. This potato is not ready yet. So these need to cook a little bit more. This one at the back, he's ready. He's hot. Woo! Hot. So these two particular potatoes, I'm going to finish them up by themselves. They were a little thicker. Actually, no, he had some big ones. So the microwave is just not cooking it evenly, right? The good heat distribution for all of the potatoes. Also, the composition of each potato is on an individual level. So I'll run it for another 3 minutes and allow those to bake off properly. That should be softer. And yes. And when we get back after these next set of messages, you will see the meals that we have actually prepared. So on a scale from 1 to 10 for household stoves and ovens, I'm gonna give this Indorama Galicia. I really hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Once again, I'm gonna give this a 7. Right, a 7. Really good house stove. By the way, my 7s are pretty good, right? If you hear me say a 9 and a 10, that's like a very awesome, perfect type of stove. Actually, you know what? I'll give this an 8 because of the rotisserie. Okay, the rotisserie, put it up a notch. Let me see what's going on. You probably don't want to get burnt. This bread has a little bit longer here on this bread. Should almost be done. And before that bread is done, I'm going to glaze it with some butter over the top, right, and give it a nice golden brown look. Okay? So yes, we will be back in a few. And then we're showing off the food and stuff like that. But for the microwave so far, I can definitely tell you the microwave is going to get a 6. Going to get a 6 on a scale from 1 to 10 for performance, right? Did expect more, you know. We had potatoes in there for over 15 minutes. You know, 20, 30 minutes in an oven is potato cooking time. So, you know, 15 minutes in a microwave seems like a little too long to be cooking 7 baked potatoes. All right, guys, and that's it for right now. I will see y'all back shortly. And remember, if you like pork chops for dinner, simple way of making them, right? We use a little salt, a little pepper. We have some of our blend seasoning, garlic, onion, shallot, a little celery, and we have ginger, okay? Ginger is an important man in that mix too, right? We didn't put no pepper in there because you can always add your peppers in the case, because we do have people who don't eat
very spicy then.
Yeah, it's very spicy food. You're about to do this thing. You have to take it off the heat. Let that cool down slightly. Get a little bit more olive oil. You can get busy. Spread that oil around nice. Let it coat that bottom. Okay, I'm actually overcooking this pork there. Not completely, but watch it.
I'm notorious for some beef, so I never talked up about this.
Oh, nice. This is for the pork. So, decent pork chop, but this one in here is actually overcooked, right? I paid attention to the potatoes and almost forgot about the pork. Right? But generally, it has a very nice look to it. Right. But none of the fat is looking fatty. Everything has been thoroughly cooked through, so that's good. Now, I will go ahead
start searing these other pieces of pork.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today or visit our website, jobfairworldwide.com.
All right, guys, welcome to the JFWW Review Show. Well, today we didn't just do reviews on the stoves and the other appliances and things that we bought from Quartz. We also did a little cooking in the kitchen and did some of our life skills show here today as well. These were two of the young men who were focused on in our life skills session today in terms of cutting vegetables, learning how to prepare fruits. They were also very instrumental in helping us cook our dinners. Right, and of course, we had this young lady here who was definitely assisting us all over the place as our main photographer and videographer, as well as one of our main runners in helping us get things done. Okay, now you're gonna be seeing some pictures of the food. Can't really tell how nice the plates would look right now because everybody's pretty hungry, so she's just demolishing hers, right? Claudius, and he's not even gonna play with his food, so I can't talk to him while he's eating. Let me just flip this camera around. Actually, let me turn it around a little bit. So this is what their plates actually look like before they started demolishing it. Hold on, we've got some feedback there from our streaming setup. All right, so in this plate here, to make sure I'm pointing to the right plate. Yes, this plate here, we have our pork chops, okay, baked potatoes, sauteed carrots and brown sugar, as well as we have a garden salad. In this plate over here, we have the steak, we have carrots, baked potatoes, and of course, the salad. Then over here, we have a pico de gallo style salsa and some official restaurant style corn tortilla chips, which is like pretty excellent.
Mm-hmm. It worked out, right? So on top of doing food reviews for other person's restaurants, right, we can do some food reviews for our own stuff as well, which is fair. We can't just go around talking about people's food and we're not preparing our own, right? That makes absolutely no sense. So now, remember, the beef that we got today, we bought from Rosignol Butchery on Church Street in Georgetown, right? It was labeled as imitation tenderloin. Right, but yeah, I think that's a robbery, right? In terms of our review for Rosignol, I will tell you that is a robbery, okay? Because it's not tenderloin at all. It's not even an imitation. They took like the hardest meat they could possibly find, made it look like a filet, and they presented it, and they're selling it at filet prices or tenderloin prices. Rosignol, you guys let me down, big time. I may have to choose a new butchery. And I might have to advise everybody else to do the same thing, unless you guys can really explain to us why you are selling imitation tenderloin at tenderloin prices, okay? Looks like you got some type of fancy little trick there. Bureau standards, should probably check that out. False advertising. But like I said, it's the only time I've ever actually had a problem buying something from you. But I personally don't think that it's tender or even close to tender, right? We have a set of beef eaters here, right? What do you think? What do you think about the food overall, the taste?
Overall, it's pretty good. Everything put together, we had the greens, we had the potatoes, we had the beef. Really good.
Is that chicken bone?
Oh, yes, from the...
Oh, that's from the chow mein. Yeah. Okay, I was wondering how you had chicken on your plate. I said, how does he have a chicken bone with like beef, right? And then you also got some other meat in there. You have pork chops in there as well. All right, yeah. And you tried the pork chop already. Way more tender, right?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, so you see, that's the difference. If your pork chop is more tender than your imitation beef tenderloin, something is seriously wrong with it.
But so what do you think?
Overall, the meal was great. So it was very well rounded. Beef, next to no marbling, and usually for steak you want a 9-10 fat ratio. Didn't happen.
So. Yeah, but other than that, now did y'all try the salad dressing? I know we're actually doing a little sampling of this Pacorama salad dressing thing. I sampled it. I hate it, personally speaking.
6 out of 10. I took the warning to heart. I didn't touch it.
Yeah. Yeah, you said 6 out of 10, man. I'm giving it more like a 3. Just simply for the fact that they had it in packaging, right? You guys need to improve that. Seriously, Pacorama people, improve your salad dressing, man. I'm willing to buy it. The packaging did look good, right? She went and bought it for me, right? So it's her fault. Her fault.
All y'all had did not come for me.
Okay. Chinese people at C&S Supermarket stock better products. Good, good. You're not gonna get me buying salad dressing or anything. Now you guys are just forcing me to make everything from scratch.
We're
talk
very
about
nice, though. Thank you.
Yeah, shishi. Yeah. Yeah, good. You see? Check that out. You see, we respect everybody, right? Yes. So we're gonna go over here to Delisa, who seems to be rating the salsa bowl, right? How's the salsa?
It's okay. It's good.
Okay.
Okay,
we are missing one person from here, but I'm gonna ask him to come over here real fast, Mr. London. I don't want you to go too far. Bring your plate with you, bring your plate with you. Okay, let me come around from this side. Yeah, so we've got Mr. London in here. No review show could be complete, like I said, without a black person in it, right? The reason why, black people, you guys have unique taste buds as well. You like good food, you like your belly. I got black in me somewhere. And I like my belly bod,
no.
Right? So, I go into the original black man inside the group right now, Mr. Livingston London, right? What are you thinking about the food so far?
The beef is too tough, is really disappointing.
All right. But the other food is all right?
Yeah.
All right, good. So, Rosignol, you see what's going on, right? Just to let you know, all of the beef and the pork came from Rosignol, but the pork was not falsely advertised. In fact, actually, yeah, it was. They advertised some chops, and in the mix, I had some different pieces of pork. So they're pulling fast stuff on people there. I think people, you need to really check your stuff out correctly when you're purchasing from them. I was very, very surprised at that type of behavior and performance from Rosignol Butchery, because I'm always out there supporting them, telling people to go and shop by them. So, you know, just because they were good one time don't mean that they're good all the time, right? So consistency, quality, standards, these things are very, very important to the community. So right now, as you can tell, I'm a little sweaty, like I'm a little hot, been cooking, been running around all afternoon, trying to make a good show for all of you, the viewers, okay? So if you appreciate what we're doing and the time that we spend in doing it, and also the work that we're doing here, trying to get young people involved, trying to get them involved in doing some life skills and knowing about quality, knowing about standards. Shoot us a message, like our video, share it with your friends, talk about it, talk good about it, hopefully. Yeah, man, let people know what we're doing. If you would like to sponsor on our show, just contact us. The number is 233-6997 and cell number 622-1957. For those of you overseas, Guyanese area code 0011592, right? And then the rest of the number. And you can actually give us a call, or you can message us through our website, jobfairworldwide.com, and see what is going on, or message us on Facebook. If you're one of our viewers on Twitch, thanks a lot for supporting the stream. Right, big up all the time. Follow us, we're gonna follow you back, we're gonna help promote you. If you're one of our viewers on YouTube or any one of the other platforms that we actually market on, advertise, do our shows on, right? Just shoot us a little heads up and we'll be happy to communicate back with you, invite you out to one of our shows, get you to sample some food, get you to come with us, wiser spending and buying things different places, and find out how people would actually treat you and if they're gonna give you value for your dollar. So once again, thank you very much. My name is Anthony and this is the JFWW Consumer Reviews Show. Take care, goodbye.
Are you tired of paying rent? Consider buying a property? Contact the West Amazon Housing Scheme. We currently have house lots available. Enjoy living in a clean and safe private community with your family. Affordable prices, low down payments, no interest fees, and easy sign-up process. Call 233-6997 to book your appointment today. or visit our website, jobfairworldwide.com.